Could work to minimise the obesity rates in this country.
It's going to force people to buy healthier food. It's going to also force people, it's going to just create a healthier society within Britain.
I'd have to say the primary danger with the government levying a tax on junk food is that it's not actually going to resolve anything, it's just going to further line their coffers. There's no, you know, I don't think we should be fooled into believing for a second that it's going to make any actual difference on obesity.
I have no problem with them taxing the food, but I'm not sure what impact they think it will have, because if people want to purchase something, they find the money to purchase it, whatever it is, if it's more what they want rather than what they should eat.
You know, there's no reason not to, because smokers get taxed, right? They know they're going to kill themselves. Mm-hmm. People who drink loads of alcohol, they get taxed.
They're just taxing people for the sake of it. It's another tax on the poor, isn't it? Because I think the larger group of people that eat junk food are poor.
Now, whether or not it's taxing junk food is the right way to go about it, I'm not sure. I'm not sure whether that affects which group in society that affects. We're going to put some kind of tax on, and then the money, where's that money going to go? Is it going to go towards the health service, I suppose, could provide some? I think I would like it to go into, if we're going to introduce some kind of tax, I think I'd want it to go into actually educating people, you know, giving them some more information, because it just tends to be that maybe in terms of society, the better off, better educated groups are the ones that know and are able to make better choices about junk food, as opposed to, maybe working class people who don't have as much information and knowledge. So I think there's a lot more to be thought about rather than just tax junk food and see where it goes. But in terms of the actual idea of reducing obesity, then there is an issue and a debate that we should be talking about.
Yeah, you can put more tax on junk food, but government need to sort of put a lot of money into education.
Well, I think education is a far better way forward in terms of making people aware of what they're eating so that they start to make better informed choices. Take label reading. So many of us are confused by the ingredients on the label and what the panels actually mean. But once you understand that, 5 grams of fat equals a pat of butter, you can start to comprehend just how unhealthy something is.
I think advertising or making people move awareness about how foods affect you and encourage people to be more involved in exercising. I'm sure they could do more about getting people to be actually fitter than just say, just a poor diet. I think there's more to it than that myself.
If you don't change the perception of the parents, then you're not going to move on and change things. You've got to change the whole ethos, and it's got to be cool to eat the healthy food, and it's got to taste good.
that drinking a pint of lager is equivalent to eating a hamburger?
I am now.
And what about a slice of cake being equivalent to drinking a glass of wine?
No.
Do you feel that alcohol is a factor in the growing obesity rate in this country?
I think it's unlikely. I don't see how the two could be linked.
I do think that alcohol's played a massive part, especially in the last 15 years with the emergence of alcopops.
If you're drinking lager, beer, I don't think people realise that that's equivalent of eating whatever, a chocolate bar or whatever. They don't realise that what it actually contains, that it's another calorie, amount of calories they've got to count.
A pint of beer should have about 180 calories in it, something like that. And a glass of wine, probably like 90.
So people will go out and probably have four beers, then go to the takeaway and have a burger or a kebab. And, you know, that people don't realise that actually they probably just had about six burgers in that time.
There should be more education, there should be more information, but it's coupled against the actual realities of being there to pay for that and get the right information to people.
It's only through the work I've done in the last year of teaching people how to read nutritional labels that I've realised just how much hidden sugars there are in food. For example, a litre of Coca-Cola has got something like 32 spoons of sugar in it.
It's, a lot of it's down to education and knowing what is healthy, what is unhealthy.
Everyone cashes in on fast food, so, I mean, yeah. Even within the home, people need to be educated on what healthy food is.
The Witch Guide did a survey of about 120 different cereals recently, and you've got the traffic light system of red, amber or green as to whether it's a healthy content. There wasn't a single cereal that didn't come out as a red for sugar.
If you look at the rate that of obesity, it's increasing throughout the country, and it's just this generation of children have been brought. They've been brought up with all this processed food,
and even the small meal deals with the sandwich, the small Coke, and the crisps. You know, that's nearly 1,000 calories.
I think people eating a lot of junk food in this country because it's so available and it's so common, really. I mean, if you walk into a newsagent, I'd say like 80% of the stuff in there is probably junk food. You see all your big stacks of chocolate bars and crisps. And
I think our whole lifestyles have got a lot busier, and we're more and more we're having to eat on the go. You know, we're having to grab something. We don't sit down for family meals anymore. And so I think it's twofold. One is we like the taste because of the extra fats and stuff that they're putting in it. And secondly, it's that we haven't got much more time to do anything else. And almost to the point of we think that cooking from scratch takes so much longer that it's much easier to take something out of a packet and put it in the microwave.
We'll go, what, Friday, Saturday night, you go out, go and get leathered. And then what do you want? Well, you certainly don't want to have, go home and make yourself a salad. You know, you want to go and get a kebab.
Hey, it can taste better, can't it? Everyone likes a treat and a snack. There can be that stuff. I think the convenience stuff is an issue in terms of, hey, I know working here, and hey, the students will joke about me always having a can of Coke and a Mars bar or something in my hand. Hey, you're rushing around, and quite often, sometimes it's not easy.
If you've grown up, if you like grow up eating junk food, you're just going to keep on eating it because you enjoy it.
Your sort of stereotypical junk food, I don't know, would be something like, I don't know, McDonald's, I suppose. You know, like that. And your healthy thing would be, you know, a bowl of, you know, muesli. You know, people think, oh, yeah, you know, I'm hungry, I've had a hard day, you know, I found, you know, the cheeseburger is going to taste better.
I think it's probably cheaper for some, and it's convenient and tasty. I think that's probably why people, in some cases, prefer junk food than healthy food.
We've got so many takeout restaurants now that just do junk food and not proper meals, which can easily still be taken out. So therefore, we're more subjected to unhealthier foods.
On nights out or when there's parties, coming home from pubs, clubs, whatever, a lot of people do pop into fast food stores like kebab shops, chip shops, just for a quick snack. It's an easy fix.
I think it's taste. If you have people like are used to having like salty, sweet, and fat.
You can buy, you know, several items from Iceland, which is absolute garbage for next to nothing.
A lot of it is down to income, and which what is the cheapest for them to buy.
Watch the telly these days, and how many adverts do you get for chocolate flavoured cereal, crisps, biscuits, all the works. It's ingrained into our lifestyle and our culture. Thank you.